In this video, you're going to learn how to build a simple PDF summarization app. Okay, so we'll get started. Let's set up our imports. So first, we're going to import Gradio to have the app, which is going to be the framework that we're going to use to actually build the actual app. Then we're going to use LangChain to do the summarization stuff. Here, I'm importing OpenAI to access the large language model and the prompt template to do custom prompts for the summarization. Then we're going to set up character. We're going to import character splitter, which we're going to use to split the text document into PDF into text chunks. Then we're going to load the summarization chain from LangChain and the PyPDF loader to load the PDF. So now I'm going to be setting up the large language model from an OpenAI. This is essentially ChatGPT, and I'm setting temperature to zero to be as precise as possible. And I'm setting up the text splitter to split the document into chunks. Now we're going to do two functions for this, one to summarize the PDF and one to do custom summaries. So first we're going to be setting up the summarize PDF function, which is going to take in the PDF file path and a custom prompt, which is going to be an empty string if I'm not doing a custom summary. But if I'm doing a custom summary, this is going to carry that custom prompt. Then inside this function, I'm going to load the PDF using the PyPDF loader class. Then I'm going to load and split the documents that I loaded the PDF with loader. Now I'm splitting that into chunks, and I'm going to save that to a variable called docs. Then I'm going to set up a summarization chain with the load summarize chain function from LangChain. And I'm going to set the chain type to map reduce. There are many ways to do this. There's like the refine method. There are a few chain types that you can experiment with, but I found that this one works pretty well. And then we're going to run our summarization on the document. And here I'm setting up a simple if, where if the custom prompt is not an empty string, I'm going to do a custom summarization. So that means what? That means that I'm going to get the custom prompt from the keyword argument in the function, and I'm going to build my prompt template using the prompt template class from LangChain. I'm feeding in the prompt template that I build using the custom prompt that I fed to this function, and I'm setting input variables text, which are going to be the essentially is what this function is going to be taking in as the custom prompt and placing it as the text to summarize. Then I'm going to summarize the content, and in the load summarization chain, I'm going to map the prompt that I just built to that load summarization chain function. So this variable goes into here so that this thing understands that it has to do a custom summary. Then I'm just going to run my custom summarization, and that's it. Finally, here, if there's no custom prompt, I'm just going to set custom summary as an empty string because this function returns both a regular summary and a customized summary. Now, essentially before I had this as a separate function, like the custom summary like this, but I didn't really like this approach. So although it's here, we're not going to be using this function. And finally, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to define a main function where we're going to actually build the app, which will have as a backend this function that's going to be doing all the summarization for us. So to build the actual app, we have to set up our inputs and outputs. So the input is going to be the PDF file path as a string. So I'm going to feed it to a text box in Gradio. Then I'm going to set up an input for the custom prompt, which is going to be the same thing, a text box in Gradio. And then I'm going to set up the output as the output summary variable, which is also going to be a text box where it's going to contain the actual summary. And then an output custom summary, which I think I'm not going to be using this one. Yeah. So I did this a few versions, and now I'm just going through the line by line with the code that I built before. But now what I'm doing is I'm setting up an iFace variable, which takes in a Gradio interface class, and then it feeds the function summarize PDF, which is the function that we built here. Then it's setting up inputs and outputs. So as inputs, it's a list with the input to the PDF file path and an input to the custom prompt, which is a just the text defining the custom prompt that we want. And as an output, we have output summary and output custom summary, which are right here. They're going to be the text boxes that are going to be storing the outputs from the summarized PDF. Remember that summarized PDF function is returning a regular summary and a custom summary if the custom prompt is fed to this function and a custom prompt. I'm sure there are better ways to do it, but this was the way that I found worked the best. Then I'm going to launch my app, and that's pretty much it. Now I'm just saying, now I'm just going to run the main function and let's test this out. So I already tested before, so it's already working here, but let's test it again and see if everything is working great. Okay, so now I click the link with the URL. Okay, that looks good. Now what we're going to be doing is I'm going to get a path for a PDF. This is something that before people had struggled with regarding the finding the path to the PDF. So I'm just going to seed the PDF file path right here. And then I'm not going to give a custom prompt. I'm just going to submit this file path. And now it's running. So it's going to take a few seconds. And once, I think usually in my machine, which is not exactly a super amazing machine, it takes a little while, but boom, there we go. This paper introduces video test former, a pre-trained video model that captures semantics and structure of instructional videos. It's evaluated on 6 downstream tasks, including step classification, mistake step detection, etc., etc. Now we can cross-check with the actual paper. And this is the paper, learning and verification of test structure instructional videos. Video task former is the name of the model that they developed. So this summary is perfectly aligned with the actual paper. And that's it. That's how you build a very simple PDF summarization app using Gradio and LangChain. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you next time. Cheers.